Welcome to Gimp Instagram Tutorial Part 1. You should have set up your workspace to look like this with very big icons. If not, go through the previous Gimp WPRK Space Setup Tutorial and set up your workspace like mine. Today's project, we are going to make an Instagram carousel. An Instagram carousel is basically a long horizontal image, which you can cut into three different pieces. When you upload into Instagram, it will look as all three different images become one image. You can download images from links below and follow the tutorial, or use your own photos and graphics. You will need a photograph, your logo in PNG with transparency, an arrow graphic. Select all the downloaded files available and open them. You should now see the icons of the import files on the top. Click on the photograph icon to open it. A small image of the photo appears in the layer section. Next to it is an eye icon. This means this layer is visible. If you don't want to see the layer, you can always close by clicking on the eye. This doesn't mean it's gone. It is just hidden from view. Clicking on the eye icon toggle between seeing and hiding the layer. There's a little bar below which you can click and drag to show you the rest of the image. But if you want to see the whole image completely inside your canvas, you can go up here under View and Zoom. Zoom fit image in window and we'll zoom out to see the full image. This is only a visual scale. It is not shrinking the image. Now we need to crop the photo. Slicing the photo into three pieces using the crop function. This icon is the crop tool. When you click on the crop tool, it will be activated. Once activated, go down and we'll be able to see more crop information. We can see there's a fixed aspect ratio. Type in 3:1. This means I want 3 times the width portion, with 1 time the height portion of the image. Go down after highlight. Select rule of thirds. The rule of third is very popular with photographers. Well known for graphical composition guidelines. A good selection to use for our project. Bring our mouse into the canvas like this. You can see there is a cross and a knife icon on it. Click and hold your mouse down. Don't release your mouse until you are on the edge like this. Once you release the mouse, you can actually scale and move the selection area around. You can move the area and just crop the building, or stretch all the way to the edge. With the rule of third on, you might want the horizon here to meet the line, making the composition more balanced. I want more skies to put my graphics elements, so I'm going to have it like this. At any time, you can undo your last action. Always remember to save your project. Under File, select Save As. Name and save the GIMP file on the desktop. We'll see you in the next chapter.